I'm sharing four of my favorite places to stay in Puerto Vallarta, specifically in the Centro and Zona Romántica neighborhoods. Each of these boutique hotels range in price from $34 to about $150 per night, and are a perfect home base for exploring this lively city. They're also great options if you're looking to try something beyond the all-inclusive resorts. We're starting with Casa Maria. This is a colorful, cheery, and uplifting hotel, located in a popular area of the Zona Romántica, only one block up from the beach and the Los Muertos Pier. This is also an adults-only hotel and has recently been remodeled, so everything felt fresh and modern. We paid $100 per night for a room with a queen bed and a balcony. I loved everything about our room. It was spacious and decorated in bright colors with Mexican charm. We had air conditioning, a full-size fridge, microwave, and a coffee pot, as well as a desk and a seating area. And I do believe that all the rooms have these amenities. There were also robes to use, as well as beach and pool towels, and even a beach bag to use during our stay. The bathroom was modern with a large shower and really good water pressure and plenty of hot water, which is kind of hit or miss in some of these smaller boutique hotels in Mexico. All the rooms have balconies or direct pool access. And it's not a very big hotel, there's only 20 rooms, so it never really felt busy here. We loved all the hotel amenities, like the courtyard pool, which had plenty of different types of seating and lounge chairs. The pool deck also has a bar with music and a bartender in the afternoons, so it was an upbeat yet still kind of a chill vibe. In the mornings, there's complimentary coffee and pastries for guests. I did find the Wi-Fi was a little spotty in the rooms, but it was strong down in the courtyard, so it was good enough to be able to do some work from the pool deck. There's also a filtered water fountain, so you always have access to fresh water. Again, the location is great, only one block up from the beach, and it's right around the corner from Pancho's Tacos. You're surrounded by cafes, restaurants, taco stands, boutique shops, everything. And despite that, this was still a pretty quiet hotel at night. We also found the best happy hour in town at Arriba, right around the corner. They had margaritas on special for 40 pesos each from 1 to 6 p.m. every single day. If you only have 2 or 3 days to spend in the Zona Romántica, this hotel is a great choice since it's so close to everything. We also met a few solo travelers here, so this hotel is really safe and a good choice if you're by yourself. Next, we have Hotel Posada de Roger. This place doesn't look like much from the outside, but it's surprisingly pretty and charming as soon as you enter. I think this hotel is the best budget option in Puerto Vallarta. Our room was $34 per night. Now that is the cheapest type of room that they have, which is an interior room with no window, but most other rooms do have a window, and they're only a few dollars more. And the most expensive rooms are only about $100, which have a private balcony and a kitchen. Our room was small and basic, but we had air conditioning, closet space, and the shower had really hot water. You can also request a small fridge for your room for $5 per day. It's definitely old, but it felt clean. And there's so many plants all around the hotel. Everything was so lush. It felt like this little tropical oasis in the middle of the city. What I really liked was that there was filtered water available 24/7 with multiple coolers on each floor. So it was very easy to access fresh water. There is a pool here. It is small and not heated, but the pool deck was nice and the loungers were very comfortable, and it had great sun all throughout the afternoon. In addition to the pool, there were lots of other amenities. The community kitchen has everything you need to make meals. We made coffee every morning, and we saw multiple people making their breakfasts as well. Inside tip though, go across the street to Yulo's Bakery, and then have your coffee and fresh pastries upstairs on one of the two rooftop patios. Gorgeous views of the surrounding neighborhood. As far as location, this hotel is situated in one of the most popular parts of the Zona Romántica and just a couple blocks up from the beach. Walking out the front door of this hotel, you have dozens of options for great restaurants and bars. As far as downsides for this hotel, the Wi-Fi was a little spotty, so it's not ideal if you need reliable internet for work, And because of the lively street that it's located on, this hotel isn't the quietest. There's quite a few bars in the immediate area, but they do offer free earplugs at the front desk. If you're not an early riser, make sure to get a room on the second floor. Our room faced the courtyard on the main floor, and it was a little noisy in the mornings when people were checking out. And if you don't have a main floor room, there are lots of stairs to get up to your room, as well as accessing the other amenities like the pool, kitchen, and patios. However, you cannot beat the price for this prime location in downtown Puerto Vallarta with a pool and kitchen space. And since it is so affordable, you should book as early as you can because this place does get booked up. It is a no-frills hotel, but it's quaint, comfy, and has all the amenities you need. Next, we have Luna Liquida, which is in Centro, just on the other side of the Zona Romántica, straight up from the Malecón. Our room was $167 per night, but that was for one of the larger rooms with a kitchen. So there are many other rooms in the $100 to $120 per night price range here. This is a relaxed hotel in a quiet part of town, and it's another small one. I believe there's only 16 rooms here. Coffee and a light breakfast is served every morning, and this included toast and fresh fruit. Now, our room was tucked away in a very quiet part of the hotel. Our room was called Corazón Dos, if you're interested in looking it up. We had a great outdoor patio, but since it was on the ground level, we didn't really have a view. But we did tour some other rooms that had fantastic views. I highly recommend any of the Sol rooms. We will definitely be booking one of those next time. But we were informed those are the most popular ones, so book ahead if you want to stay here. There's two communal kitchens where you have everything you need to prepare your own meals, as well as fridges to keep your drinks cold. And I mean, the rooftop pool was breathtaking. This is the star of the hotel. We stayed here for 5 nights and never got sick of this view. We would get up early with our coffee and watch the cruise ships roll in, and then watch the sunsets from here. It truly was the perfect hotel to relax, unwind, and decompress. There wasn't anything I disliked about this hotel, but there are a couple things worth mentioning. It is located about 4 blocks straight uphill, and some sections are steep. And then within the hotel, there are lots of stairs. So if you have trouble with stairs, this will be a difficult hotel for you. The pool isn't heated, so it was a little chilly, but it was still refreshing when the sun was out and it was hot. We found one of our favorite restaurants to eat, which was just down the street from this hotel, across from the Guadalupe Cathedral, and it had some of the best authentic Mexican food at really good prices. Or for a more sophisticated meal, visit La Capella Restaurant, just 1 block away, for an elegant Italian meal. So I think Luna Liquida is a great hotel for longer stays, or if you want to feel like you're living in a local neighborhood instead of being a tourist. Finally, we have Rivera del Rio. Tucked away close to the Isla Coale, the Coale River, this hotel oozes luxurious, whimsical charm and rustic elegance. Each room is uniquely decorated with romantic old world vibes. It's one of the best hotels we've ever stayed in. We paid $180 per night, but there are several other rooms available for $120, $140, and $150 per night. And we could have saved some money if we booked earlier, so keep that in mind as well. If you love historic areas and staying somewhere more unique and off the beaten path, this is the hotel for you. And it's perfect if you're on a honeymoon. I also think it's a good stepping stone hotel if you want to try something different from the all-inclusive resorts. There are only 20 rooms here. The rooms have king beds and private balconies with incredible views, and all the rooms have air conditioning. We stayed in the Zelda room, and loved the luxurious rainfall showerhead, which complemented the open-air view to the neighborhood below. The best thing about this hotel, though, is the heated rooftop infinity pool. It offered 360-degree views of the ocean, the high-end neighborhoods, and the mountains. In the afternoons, there's a bartender mixing drinks and a daily happy hour. And I cannot stress enough, the lavish sunsets are spectacular from up here. There's also another quiet pool and a rooftop jacuzzi hot tub. A hot breakfast is served each morning in the airy dining nook, and you have several choices to choose from, like classic egg dishes, avocado toast, or pancakes. Also, this hotel is dog-friendly, and it's a really convenient location as the river park is across the street, and it's also 5 minutes away from a dog park. As far as location, it's an 8 to 10 minute walk to the beach and the Malecon because it is kind of tucked away in a nice little corner of the Zona Romantica, and because of that, it is the quietest hotel on the list. If you have any questions about any of these hotels, drop them in the comments. As always, I pay full price for my hotel rooms so I can provide my objective opinion. You'll find links to each hotel in the video description so you can check prices and availability. And remember that prices can and do fluctuate based on time of year and vacancy. I invite you to check out my other videos or dozens of blog posts about Puerto Vallarta and the surrounding area. Thanks for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.